I had not been back there in years, but it was the last place left to look. It was not exactly as I remembered it, but it wasn't all that different either. Pockets, barrels, butter churns, and beds were jammed into every nook and cranny of that cave. It all seemed so familiar. Even though the bed was very comfortable, this was no time to hide under the covers.
Wait. Hold on, Grandpa. I don't remember this part of the story. Beds hanging from stalactites?
We'll get there, Gwendolyn. Don't worry. No detail in this story will be overlooked. Now, where was I? Ah, yes. As I treaded through the river of rumbling trundles, I feared I knew the source of that deafening wind. Nestled beneath a slumbering pile of teeth and claws was...
Fabled mirror!
Oh, so you remember this part of the story.
Well, dragons are my favorite.
Do you want to tell this part?
Yes. King Edward sent me, the greatest knight in all of Daventry, on a quest to return his stolen mirror. A gigantic, hulking beast of a dragon was the last thing in my way to...
my way to add a shinier hat to my collection. I tried to turn that crazy contraption, but it was missing a handle. Someone tampered with it, creating some silly conundrum.
So the missing handle was booby-trapped? What did you do?
Well, I used my cleverness to outsmart the trap. Then I used my cleverness to hide. Luckily, that half-blinded beast never noticed me in bed.
A dragon's eye must be really hard to pierce with an arrow. At archery lessons, I can barely hit a hay bale.
It is indeed a feat only for skilled archers. I tried to turn that crazy contraption, but it was missing a handle. Someone tampered with it, creating some silly conundrum.
What did you use to fix the...
The dragon's chains were coiled around a gigantic switch mounted to the cave wall. This cave seemed to be filled with failed adventures. After he briefly basked in the sun, the narcoleptic dragon went back to snoring.
I'd probably sleep all day too, if Amira was my only friend. Whoever designed this trap thought they were pretty clever, but I would probably find a way to hit that unbreachable switch. The mirror called out to me. A ridiculous feeding contraption was cobbled together to keep the beast and probably its owner alive. With a magic mirror safely in my possession, I dreamt of the Daventry I would be rewarded with, and the kingdom it could become. I had three choices in front of me. Any would clear my path to safety, and all would have rippling consequences. After gracefully rappelling down the cliff, I welcomed the sight of an actual road, the first sign of civilization. I could have sworn the parade of hopeful knights was scheduled for the next day. I should have been with them, marching with triumph. It seemed my first few minutes in Daventry were off to a terrible start.
So, how did you catch up with them?
Strange tracks blazed a trail through the forest. I wondered what those birds needed a toolbox for. Shame. The only tool left seemed to be a small hatchet. And no, Gwendolyn, before you start asking me thousands of questions about that hatchet, I did not go around using it on everything.
It's just a boy. Don't know where he's from, but it must be hard to pronounce.
You know, you should never sneak up on a guy in a dangerous place like... Oh! What's wrong with your foot? Probably stepped on a spiniferous thornweed. Don't worry, I got just the fix for that. Tell me, is it more of a... Ow! Or a... Oh, oh! Either way, the Merchant of Miracles has got you covered. But it'll cost you. I've risked my neck to forge the most rare, miraculous, mysterious, and oftentimes delicious ingredients. Ah, here it is. I massage this into my skin twice a day, and just look at my little biscuits. Well, now that I've mulled it over, you'd better not. It might stunt your growth. Ooh, such exquisite material.
Hey.
I knew you weren't from around here. Well, you best get going. Nobody likes a late night. Oh, wait. You're stuck here with me. Every virgin is out. And my shortcut had a few shortcomings. I swear that rock leaped straight out of the water. Now I'm stuck here with no wheel, a lost toolbox, and Mr. Fancy Cakes. Say, what? I'll bet a fine, strapping young man like you could help me fix up this wheel. Yep, you help me fix my chariot, and I'll give you a lift to the tournament. Hopefully no one else notices your horrible lack of punctuality. Oh, how rude. Do you have any questions for me?
Nope.
That missing wheel had me stumped. I had to go out on a limb to get past the root of the problem.
Ugh. Grandpa, your infamous puns are not my favorite.
What's the matter? You don't like the timbre of my voice? You'll warm up to the puns.
These are terrible.
Square was eerily quiet. Was I the only person in Daventry not at the parade? Looked like a blacksmith shop of sorts. That sign was asking for tips, and there was a metal pan to collect coins.
You cut?
They probably needed the money more than I did. Big, round, that should do the trick. Ah, a shortcut.
Do I really have to hear the story about how you took forever to tiptoe across that fallen tree? Again?
No, I guess not.
I thought this might do the trick.
A shield, eh? Whoa, it matches impeccably with the delicately crafted color scheme of this entire operation. Makes quite the bold statement. Mm-hmm, just like my shorts. This is perfect. I hope you didn't pay too much for it. Oh, wait, before my mind slips, I was able to procure an entrance ticket to the tournament. Since you so graciously found me a wheel, I am more than willing to sell it to you at a reasonably discounted rate. Are you interested?
Oh, sounds good. I love a deal.
So do I, boy. So do I. If I see one, I'll let you know. Here you are. Now, let's vamanoosie from this meadowland, Mr. Fancy Cakes. It is go time. Mr. Fancy Cakes! Heel! Halt! Avast! Stop! We sincerely hope you enjoyed your stay in our luxury cabin. Please gather your belongings and watch your head on exit.
Thanks for the hospitality.
No time to lounge, my boy! Lucky for you, the parade is halted. Another case of a mysterious missing bridge, I imagine. Watch your step! We wouldn't want any tears in that illustrious cape! Bon voyage, Buttercup! Don't forget about us working folk, especially when your pockets are full of riches.
Back away, back away! This area is unsafe for commoners. Stay off those rocks! It's dangerous! Distress!
Abandon post!
Learn how to swim, boy.
Thanks for saving me.
You're welcome, lad.
He was talking to me.
I believe he was talking to me.
Nope, his tired argument is getting on my nerves.
No need to argue about the fact that I am...
Uh-oh.
Oh, dear. Not good.
Bees! Bees!
Over here, buddy.
Pardon me! All right!
I left the hatchet lodged in the tree because I would not need it anymore.
Are you sure?
Quite sure. Everyone always asks about that hatchet. It gets a tad annoying.
Hang on a sec. Graham, right?
Yes. How did you know my name?
Well, you'd be surprised at the information people give out when they're too busy thinking about their own agenda. I also observed that without you, no one could have made it across. Well done, Graham.
Thanks, I guess.
They'll never acknowledge it, you know. Those who use their minds over their biceps are never woven into the tapestries of time. I can tell you're like me, a creative thinker, an intellectual. To win this competition, you'll need to prove that your talents are more powerful than their strength, agility, and speed. You'll also need a friend.
I can really use a friend.
They call me Manny. Pleased to meet you.
So, friend, what's your favorite color? Do you like popcorn-flavored jelly beans? Because I do. What's your availability for sleepovers? Are we in a secret club?
Green. I prefer pizza-flavored. I'm free on Wednesdays and Saturdays, and I would say more of a secret alliance.
Alliance?
This competition will not be easy, and Daventry needs men like us. If we put our heads together, we might have a shot.
What's the plan?
If you win, put a good word in for me with the king. And if I win, I'll do the same. Soon, we'll both be moving up the ranks in the castle together. We should head inside the theater, though.
Let me know how I can help.
Graham, to the front of the stage, please.
Now that we have recovered our list, it is my duty to inform you that you are officially signed in. Yay. And I do want to apologize. I am very, very terribly sorry. But we've run out of commemorative tote bags.
That's not a problem. I have no use for tote bags. My mother designed my cape with lots of pockets. Is the next event about to start?
Not so fast, Pocket Boy. The tournament bylaws explicitly state that each contestant must complete every event before continuing on in the competition. Since you were late, you missed the test of chivalry and the welcoming parade, both designed as light-hearted warm-ups and getting-to-know-you type exercises. You know, an icebreaker, before we start in on the usual death, destruction, and duels of a cutthroat nature.
Don't forget about Amendment 70, Article 4.
I was getting to that, thank you. In the spirit of equal opportunity, the new rules state that you can schedule a make-up chivalry test if and only if the circumstances for your absence were extenuating. So, I will ask, what were your extenuating circumstances that made you late for the tournament?
Well, my mom whipped up a stack of my special choco chip pancakes, and she never lets me leave the house until I finished all my breakfast.
Mm-hmm. I'll just pencil in Mummy's boy. Now, go on, mingle with the other contestants. Find out as much as you can about them, and when you're ready for the chivalry test, come and see me.
Hey, thanks for knocking that log over out there. Really, it gave me the opportunity to go on a lovely cruise.
Those nights were annoying me, and I wanted some alone time. Leave me be, little fly. You don't want to wake the bull.
Look, I don't want to be in this conversation any more than you do, but I missed the chivalry test, and I need to make it up. The faster we get this over with, the faster I can leave you alone.
Well, make it quick, then buzz off.
I'm Graham. Graham
No. No last names. I don't even want your first name.
And your name?
I'm known throughout the land as Circumference. But I am currently in the process of rebranding myself, starting with my name. You should call me Acorn.
What was that you were hiding in your paws?
Well, none of your business, Feather Boy.
I'll leave you be.
Go away!
Key. Oh, hey, Graham. We were just sharing some tips about the tournament. Let me know if you want the rundown about any of our competitors.
What can you tell me about Acorn?
I can tell you not to mess with those bullhorns in any strength competition. I shouldn't be telling you this, but I heard a rumor that the man keeps a pet squirrel under his belly. What kind of a weirdo does that? Imagine what else he's hiding under there. Neither of us is going to be able to match his strength. If we're going to oust him, we'll need to work together and expose his secrets.
I'm good. Thanks, Manny.
Goodbye!
Nearly unearthed.
Hey there, I'm Graham.
Charmed, I'm sure.
And your name?
What?
Well, I didn't catch your name.
What? Is this true? Surely you jest, Greg. What rock did you crawl out from? How do you not recognize this well-proportioned face?
Well, it's not Greg, it's Graham. And, of course, I know who you are. You're... Sir Ten of himself.
Cheeky. But now you're starting to bother me, Grant.
I couldn't help it. No, but seriously, you're... That jerk who pushed me into the river...
Oh, yes, that silly feather does look familiar. Look at it. Like a limp piece of cheese. What you need, Gale, is an upgrade. Like... My mane of excellence.
Hey, my mother gave me that feather. I might be silly, but you're... going to have to wait 1 second. I'll be right back.
I'll be waiting right here, Garrett.
When we see you...
What do you want?
I heard what you're hiding.
No, you didn't, skinny pants.
I did. I heard a rumor that a tiny squirrel pet lives under your belly.
What? Who told you that? I bet it was Whisper. He's the worst. His ego is the one thing I can't stomach. And she's not my pet. She's my friend.
Does your squirrel friend have a name?
I wish Whisper would keep his big mouth shut. Her name is Princess Madeline of Avalon. She's a proper lady.
What else is hidden in that belly?
The bones of a feather boy if you don't leave me alone.
I think you're hiding something else in there, but I'm not sure I want to find out. I'll leave you be.
You need to get lost.
Unveiled itself. It bared its... Yes? Have you remembered my name?
Whisper.
Correct. Well, Whisper's full name is Sir Walter Harris Ignatius Sally Percival Eduardo Ramon Jr. the Third, hailing from Modesto. But I'm sure a fan like you knew that. Would you like an autograph?
Huh, I don't seem to have any portraits on me.
Well, if you find one, I'll sign it, free of charge. Whisper loves his fans. Whisper loves the knighthood. Whisper loves thwarting evil. But most of all, Whisper loves Whisper.
As do we all. I should be getting back to my chivalry test now.
Don't go! Whisper can do it!
That's a nice thought, but I'm pretty sure those guards would never confuse you for me. I mean, your armor is pretty recognizable.
Whisper's armor is shiny, because Whisper loves his own reflection.
Yeah, I get it. Good day, Whisper.
Are you ready for the chivalry test?
Let's do it!
Question one. Who is the only knight competing in the tournament that speaks multiple languages?
Manny, we're friends, you know. We have kind of an alliance. Next question.
All right, next question. This knight hopeful hails from a land far outside of Daventry. Based on the odds, he is favored to win the competition.
Server of Arrows?
Okay, moving on. What is the full name of the fastest contestant in the competition?
Sir Walter Harris Ignatius Sally Percival Eduardo Ramon Jr. III of Modesto. I'm sure of it.
I see. Last question. Who or what is the favorite companion of the strongest competitor?
Princess Madeline of Avalon. She sounds quite charming.
Okay, let's see here. Tallying. It looks like you got 3 answers correct. Why don't you go and mingle? Gather some more fun facts about your fellow competitors. Return to me when you're ready to take the test again.
Hello, my name's Graham. Nice to meet you.
Achaka.
Good chat. I'm gonna get back to the chivalry test.
Yes, Graham? You want some dirt on someone?
What can you tell me about Achaka?
I'm studying his every move. He should make any opponent quiver. You got me doing it now. He's fast, strong, and vicious with his bow. I'm trying to convince him to join our alliance, but the translation isn't quite working.
I'm good. Thanks, Manny.
Goodbye!
Are you ready for the chivalry test?
Let's do it!
Question 1. Who is the only knight competing in the tournament that speaks multiple languages?
Manny, we're friends, you know. We have kind of an alliance. Next question.
All right, next question. This knight hopeful hails from a land far outside of Daventry. Based on the odds, he is favored to win the competition.
Achaka.
Okay, moving on. What is the full name of the fastest contestant in the competition?
Sir Walter Harris Ignatius Sally Percival Eduardo Ramon Jr. III of Modesto. I'm sure of it.
I see. Last question. Who or what is the favorite companion of the strongest competitor?
Princess Madeline of Avalon. She sounds quite charming.
Okay, let's see here. Tallying. It looks like you got all the answers correct. Great job, Pockets. Now, we shouldn't keep your new friends waiting, should we? Let's start the show.
Welcome, everybody. You are all here to win a knight position on King Edward's court. But that's not all. As you all know, tragically, the king has no heirs. So, this position could very well lead to the crown of Daventry itself. Now, let's officially commence the competition part of the tournament. I do hope you've all made friends, because it's about to get nasty. The time has come to collect your entrance tickets.
Over here! I got mine right here!
I'm sorry, I really am, but that is not an entrance ticket. In fact, from up here, it looks like a sweaty piece of cloth. Oh, probably just a snot rag. Each knight hopeful will need to bring back to the theatre, dum-tum-tum-tum, one eye of a hideous beast. And, due to Proclamation 1748.2, it will actually need to be a hideous beast. Not like last year. No adorably cute, fuzzy or tiny creature eyes will be accepted. Thank you.
Nothing to see here.
There are many hideous eyes to find in Daventry. We urge you to take this opportunity to show us your skills. We want to know what's in your heart, how you think, and how you react in the face of danger. You might not believe all that can be interpreted from one eye, but we will still judge you all the same. Now, everyone, go forth and claim thine eyes.
Whisper!
Ooh.
Whisper can do it!
Watch your step, kid.
Oh, thanks.
I know it ain't fancy, but it'll have to work for now. Amaya Blackstone, nice to meet you.
Graham, the pleasure's mine. It's nice to see all these bridges are getting fixed.
All these bridges? No, kid. This contract is over. Daventry can't afford me anymore. They can't even afford oil for the crumbler over there. My own invention, of course.
Oh, what does a crumbler do?
It lifts, it chops, it crumbles. Most importantly, it brings in the monies, which are desperately needed. Been kind of rough around here lately.
It seems that way. Daventry's been an interesting experience so far. Different from what I read in my travel books. Honestly, I'm starting to wonder if it's for me.
Don't worry, kid. It's not you. This kingdom's been going downhill ever since the Queen died. And now, with the bridges out, no one can get into Daventry. It's really quiet. I hate the silence. I'm a woman of action, if you couldn't tell. Quiet towns don't pay the bills.
I can see that.
Well, I should get going. Perhaps someone's wandered into my shop. If you make it there, come say hi. I'm on the left.
So, how did you find an eye?
The badger wanted to make friends with the squirrels.
Get out of here! Scram! Shoot! Beat it! Ugh, these dumb lanterns are always breaking. You hear that, Chester? You're a hack! Not everyone around here takes pride in their work like I do. Unfortunately, those blue flames are the only things that spook the pack. So I'm forced to return to their shop of wizardry and toiletries. Wedzel wolves are super aggressive this time of year. Usually, they travel north to the hills of Serenia for mating season. But like us, they are stranded here until the bridges are fixed. Hey, kid, can you do me a favor?
I can try.
Can you help me keep that back door closed? I run the local Wedzel Wolf Watch program here in town. There's patches getting made. If you keep that door closed, you can be an official member. Think it over. Patches!
I walked into town with my last coin. Whatever path I chose to pursue for my eye would need to be cheap.
You aren't the delivery boy, are you? That merchant is usually so prompt with our air, miraculous, and oftentimes delicious ingredients.
Oh, hush feathers, Chester. This boy's no courier. He desires a position in King Edward's court. He appears to be a compassionate gentleman, but he is clearly out of his comfort zone. He is one who needs to think more with his brain and less with his heart if he is going to defeat the contenders in this year's night tournament.
Zounds! Did you just read my fortune?
No, we're just very old and very judgmental people.
It's true, we're judges. This is my judging face.
Uriel and I don't read fortunes anymore.
Yep, there was no future in it.
Well, we've shifted our core business to potions, curiosities, and the occasional practical joke. We gladly share our wisdom for free, but everything else starts at one shiny gold coin.
Take a look around, boy. Let us know if you like anything you see.
Yes.
So, I've just gotta know, what is brewing in that cauldron? Is it a transfiguration elixir? Is it an invincibility potion? If I drink it, will I understand the language of creatures? Will I sprout the wings of an eagle? Or a fly?
Oh, this? Teeth-whitening potion.
Oh, it's gonna change everything.
Watch this. Behold the power of whitening!
Oh, well, we're still working out the kinks. While we're still in the prototype phase, feel free to dip whatever you want in there free of charge.
Fare thee well.
May your shoes point you towards adventure and click whatever danger is near.
Hello there, and good afternoon. Forgive the shop from lacking our usual favorites. With all the bridges out and my supplier missing, I can't keep all my delicious treats stocked. But have a look around. I'm here to answer any questions. Yes, lad?
What's today's special?
Oh, well, today I am baking up quite the treat. Grandma's star shroom pie! A delicacy big enough to feed an army! Or someone with the appetite of an army. I've eaten it in one sitting before. Well, don't judge. No one would trust a skinny baker, now would they? Unfortunately, my ingredients haven't been delivered, and I can't complete the recipe. Until those bridges get fixed, people will just have to settle for the love in my goat hoof pie instead. Ah, tell you what. If you can find me some starberries and sugar shrooms, you can have this monster pie for the discounted price of 1 gold coin.
Good day.
Oh, great day!
Hey, Graham. If you like sharp things, you've come to the right place.
We have over 23. Oh, forgive me.
Last night was a little rough. I woke up on the floor, my bed nowhere to be found. Can you believe that? What type of yahoo steals a bed while you're sleeping in it? And the most curious part, nothing else is missing. Usually, that sleep depriver would be hunted down and fed to the crumbler. But today is different. Today, I sold a shield while I was out watching the parade, and money always puts me in a better mood. Anyway, take a look around. Let me know if something piques your interest.
Oh!
Don't touch that, Graham, or you might be the one losing an eye. Hello.
So, I've been meaning to ask. What is that amazing blade for? Is it for battling vicious werebears? How many ice orcs has it slain? Does it deal justice? Is it road legal? Is it made of fear?
Oh, that? No, that's for gardening. I use it to trim my hedges. Seeing as my place is all tended to, and my petunias are most lovely, I'm willing to part with it for the price of 1 shiny gold coin. I'm sure you've got a prickly situation that needs attending.
How much for that gardening tool?
1 shiny gold coin.
Bye.
Forget what those other guys say. A sword is mightier than a pen.
Did you do it? Did you spend your only gold coin on the epic weed whacker?
I did. The bold costs a fortune.
Now, Graham, promise me you will only use this for its intended purpose.
I shall be brave in all my hedge trimmings.
Those plants will never see it coming.
was a few steps behind, but I was hopeful a beast was in that well, and I wanted an eye to impress everyone.
But Grandpa, the dragon lives down there.
I didn't know that yet, Gwendolyn, and pretend you don't either. This story takes place before the one I told you last night. Sometimes a story is best told out of order.
Oh, got it.
I was out of my league down there, but I had something to prove.
Hey! Whatever's down here, it's mine.
There wasn't much to see that way, so I turned around and went back.
Stalama. Afamata. Asta Afamata. Afamata? Afamata. Wata. Afamata. 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 Stalama. Stalama. Afamata. 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 Wata.
Excitement. I took the long way, he took the astounding way. No matter, that eye would be mine.
Affanata!
Uka!
Stalama! Stalama!
Uka!
Affanata!
Uka!
Affanata! Hey, good looking out.
Achaka! Buta!
Affanata.
Puta!
Afana.
Buta?
Stalama.
Ooh. Buta?
Stalama.
Puta!
Afana.
Buta!
Afana.
Buta!
Stalama.
Buta!
Afana.
Buta!
Afana.
Buta!
Afana.
Buta!
Afana.
Buta!
Stalama.
Puta!
Off and up. Off and up.
Buta.
Stalama.
Buta.
Off and up.
Buta.
Stalama.
Buta!
Off and up.
Hey, do you think we could share that dragon eye?
Shreki, Afamata.
My thoughts exactly.
Shreki. Buddha.
Afanada! I'm done. I am done. This is not for me.
Going somewhere?
Yes, I'm going home, where I belong. I was promised wonder and adventure and fantastical floating islands. And what I got was a Daventry that will never live up to what it once was.
Daventry needs you, Graham. I know it's not what you expected, but give it time. We can work through the kinks together. It can be great once again with the right people in charge.
I'm not that person. And you should stop believing in me. It could get you killed.
Fine. Leave. Be a dentist for all I care. I guess Sachaka was wrong.
What?
Nothing. It was nice meeting you, Graham.
Spill it.
Well, Sachaka and I were chatting during your chivalry test, and he had some thoughts about you. Didn't you find it odd that Sachaka entered this tournament, Graham? Did he ever tell you why?
Well, he might have, but I only learned two words of his language.
A horrendous famine struck Achaka's village, Ichtue. He left his suffering family to enter this tournament. He hoped to seek an audience with the king to plead for help. It was a long shot, even for him.
Oh, great. So because of me, a whole village will starve. That makes me feel better.
No. Because of you, a village will be saved. Sachaka was impressed by you. He told me he was watching you on your travels to Daventry, and that you seemed like the type of person that could inspire change. More so than those bucketheads, anyways. If you're not going to compete for yourself or me, do it for the Ichtuans. They need you. You're their last hope.
For those brave souls that are still with us, welcome back. Now, you may have heard some squawking from a few naysayers in our kingdom concerned with the ethics of the tournament. But proclamations and addendums aside, this is the way we have always done it in Daventry. And this is the way we will continue to do it. Now, knight hopefuls, if you would be so kind as to present your eyes.
Hold still.
Thank you. I'd look happier if that was my eye.
I'd look less happy if that was my face.
Look who's talking.
Yes, look who is talking.
Congratulations, everybody. We officially accept all the eyes presented. I'll see you in the duels.
Take that and that!
Oh, Mr. Springbottom. What? You're surprised I'm competing in the stuffed animal tournament? You know what? I will make some stories of my own. I'll pick up where my last book left off. It was called 31 Ways to Slay a Monster. Yarr! Arr! Ya-ya! Hi-ya! Hi-ya! That's what you get, Mr. Springbottom. Hi-ya!
Gwendolyn!
I'm sorry, Grandma.
Oh, I'll take care of it, dear. I came to tell you your grandfather is ready for you. Run along, go have some adventures. Just try to have your next adventure away from my glass vases, please.
Now it's time for my favorite part of the tournament, the duels. Ha ha! You will compete against each other in a duel of strength and a duel of speed, with the winners facing off in a championship duel of wits.
The pairings of knights were selected at random, so no complaining. I'm looking at you, Whisper.
Any ties will be settled in sudden death. The winner, of course, will gain the knight position.
The duel of strength will take place at our fantastical and wondrous floating island.
And bring your steed to the tournament theatre for the duel of speed.
Please unveil the tournament board.
I will remain here for any questions.
Good luck!
Questions?
Where exactly is the Duel of Strength?
The Duel of Strength will take place on Daventry's own fantastical, wondrous floating island. Head north, then east. You can't miss it.
What do I need for the Duel of Speed?
Bring your trusted steed to the tournament theatre when you're ready for the Duel of Speed. You do have a trusted steed, don't you?
Bye!
Toodles.
Shoo! Get off that hay bale! Out of those flowers! Put that sack lunch down! No patch for you. You know why. I was wrong about you, Graham. I heard the guards gossiping about it. Such an amazing trophy. Please cherish it forever. What can I get you?
Bye.
Don't forget leg day!
I better stand on this side of the rock.
It wouldn't budge. Oh, what a peculiar trap.
Yeah.
Moving any further in the dark seemed like a bad idea. I'd always been a straight shooter, but Ataka opened my eyes.
All right, that one wasn't that bad.
Well, thank you.
Take out all those goblins.
With swiftness or patience. You'll have to wait and see.
Me, you fiends! Oh, nice shot! Time for you rocks to roll! Boy! That is your name, right? Boy, thank the shining stars! Where did you learn to shoot like that? Now, I'm not a native goblin tongue, but I'm pretty sure I made out the words unicorns and majestic museum. Mr. Fancy Cakes is too barbarous for a caged life. Listen, I want to sincerely apologize for my pilfering sausages, and thank you for saving me.
Give me my money back, you dirty merchant!
No problem, no problem at all. Let's see here. One, two, three, one! There you go. I'd give you more, but those hoarding goblins looted my cart. And since we are all square, I have a favor to ask of you. Can you deliver this rare and miraculous ingredient to that amateur magic shop in town? It's a snoozing leaf. Be careful transporting it, though. Once Mr. Fancy Cakes ate one of these snoozing leaves and was knocked out cold for days. Well, gotta run. Good thing these shorts breathe so well. Thanks again, boy! I won't forget this! Sadanararia!
Did the merchant remember that?
Ha! The merchant immediately forgot that. Starberries framed a serene view. Shame about that buzzing beehive, though. My love, you're my everything. I might not have enough money for a ring yet, but I just can't wait any longer. Will you be mine forever? I better put this back. Someone had set the scene for a lovely evening.
Get over here. We're waiting. We used all the rafts, so figure it out.
This was on my bucket list.
I had to use two rafts to get across.
There was an extra raft,
so
the Princess Madeline used it for herself. When she travels, she demands only the best. If Princess Madeline ever left me, do you think Mr. Fancy Cakes could fit under my belly?
That didn't fit there. That.
No one should notice one bell missing.
Joy, Graham the Brave is here.
Ah, the little boy who wants to do big things.
Congratulations on making it to the next round of the tournament.
Our crystal ball told us about the eye you presented.
Wasn't the cleverest way of going about things, was it?
You seemed like such a nice boy.
Hopefully you'll use your noggin a bit more in the future. Oh. We don't need any more brash knights in Daventry.
No matter your choice in life, we will gladly take your money.
Business is business. Now, Chester, can you hand me the frog's breath elixir?
Frog's breath elixir? Yes, where is that? We seem to be out of...
You drank it all again, didn't you?
Muriel, my blood sugar was low.
Mm-hmm.
It's just so tasty.
Since you can't keep your mitts off our supplies, we are halting production. This potion will have to wait until that merchant brings us our delivery.
If you find a frog, bring it directly to me, and I will gladly trade you a sample of this potion. And then I'll have to drink the delicious froggy leftovers.
Until then, no more free dips. Our order is finally here. Well, part of it anyway. Chester, remind me to leave a poor review for that merchant on the town board.
Ah, this should do the trick.
Mmm. It's close, but it still needs that frog's breath.
Well, I'm glad I could help further it along.
Yes, and as a token of our appreciation, we would like to give you this... This vial of hypnotic powder. Oh, it's expired.
It can work. It was just never finished.
Let me guess. It's missing lollipop root or baby's tears. I can bring you a tuft of Mr. Fancy Cakes fur.
Nope. It just needs raisins. Here.
Thanks.
I guess.
Graham, a little squirrel told me the news. Oh, I'm deeply sorry you lost a friend. This horrible tournament spawns a vicious cycle of violence every year. When will Daventry recognize that slaying ferocious beasts shows no heart? An innocent creature lost his eye, and a good man lost his life. But what do I know? I'm just a humble baker. Please, let me know if there's anything I can do in your time of need. Perhaps Grandma's sugar shroom pie can ease the pain a little. I am here to serve.
So, where can I find the ingredients for that giant pie?
I'll also need one gold coin. But which ingredient?
Never mind. Good day.
Don't desert me! Oh, is Chester up to no good again?
Hasn't anyone told you it's not polite to go stomping around on people's backs? Give me one good reason not to gobble you up right now.
If you let me go, I can return to you with bundles of royal food. You see, I'm training to be a knight. If you release me, I'll make sure the king rewards you for your troubles.
You're a little scrawny for a knight. A long neck and a silly feather like that? Are you sure you aren't a goose?
Yes, I am quite sure I am not a goose.
That's exactly what a goose would say. Lucky for you, Ulfie hates the taste of goose. The feathers are bad for digestion. Now, where do you want from Ulfie, Goosey?
Is there any way you could let me cross?
I'm not supposed to do this. But Ulfie needs to pick me up. If you bring Ulfie back a snack to satisfy his sweet tooth, Ulfie might consider letting little Goosey pass.
Happy trails.
Waddle back briskly, Goosey. Ulfie is starving.
Was a hideous beast lurking inside.
What are you doing this weekend?
Oh, you know, taking the old lady out dance.
Shame. These could have been carved into really nice jack-o'-lanterns. That didn't need it.
That needs to be used on raisins. Otherwise, you're just wasting it.
A new kind of horn, but the same result. That didn't need a bell. I was too slow to catch those frogs. I tried again, but it was no use. I ruined the bee's day and that lovely meal. I tucked the berries away for later, even though I was craving a cliffside snack.
Hurry up and get over here! This guard is starting to creep me out. Seriously, get over here. He's one of those guys who smells like syrup.
So picky. Bales are always good for a distraction or two. The only thing we can sell you for one gold coin is that blue-flamed lantern. It's broken, though, and needs something to house it. He reminds me of our son.
I always miss him this time of year.
He dreamed of becoming a knight, too. I wish he would visit more.
Or at least write. He was quite handy around the shop, though. Especially with potions.
He'll return. He just has some adventures of his own to seek.
What are these little guys?
Those are bird bombs. Our own invention.
Kinda like a smoke bomb, but they release gas that will cause your victim to cluck like a chicken. Temporarily, of course.
Those ones are expired, though, so they're just for display.
It looked like some type of broken lantern.
You poked?
I did.
The only thing we can sell you for one gold coin is that blue-flamed lantern. It's broken, though, and needs something to house it.
Looks like we could put some love on those bones.
How do I get my free sample?
Well, bring me some bitterroot. It's what I need to finish my walnut strudel. It grows under big, heavy rocks.
Good day.
Don't get in any rhubarbs. These starberries are perfectly ripe. Just squishy enough. And with a faint scent of musky cabbage. Now, if you can find me the sugar shrooms, she's all yours. For the discounted rate of one shiny gold coin. How can I help?
So, where can I find the ingredients for that giant pie?
I'll also need one gold coin. And I already have the starberries. But which ingredient?
The sugar shrooms.
They are pink and only grow in cold, dark areas.
Never mind. Good day.
Have a crepe day.
Dearie, where are my dried reptile skins?
Well, where did you leave them?
The only thing we can sell you for one gold coin is that blue-flamed lantern. It's broken, though, and needs something to house it.
Kitty, kitty, not a kitty, not a kitty!
There was absolutely nothing you could do, Graham. Achaka would have met the same fate with or without you. You are the only adventurer to have ever survived that well. That despicable dragon has murdered countless knights, and you are the only one to have wounded him. Achaka's spirit lives on inside you. Let his arrow guide you through the rest of this competition. It's no consolation, but I want you to be my apprentice next spring. Perhaps we can avenge Achaka's death together.
I'm not so sure about this. I think I need to find another path.
Your story's not yet written, Graham. This is only the beginning. Find your path. Even if it leads you right back to where you started. Hello.
Bye.
Trust that gut of yours. Back away from the crumbler. Unless you have 50 gold coins for a work order. You can post a work order on anything you want lifted, chopped, or crumbled. Then I'll bring out Mrs. Crumbler to fulfill the order.
That did.
That needs to be used on raisins. Otherwise, you're just wasting it.
Was a hideous beast lurking inside.
It's a good thing we're auditioning potential.
Like?
A generous man. Without him, you and I would not be sitting here. He trusted me with his final request, knowing that no adventure was too daunting for the feather in my cap.
I still can't believe you ever weren't king.
I wasn't strong enough to move that rock.
That needs to be used on rape.
That did.
Seems like a waste of money.
All right, sugar shrooms.
Wow, these sugar shrooms look amazing. Just the right amount of shroomy and not too sugary. Now, if you pass me one shiny gold coin, Grandma's giant star shroom pie is all yours. Oh, thanks for the patronage. Share this pie with a friend or two, or three. And good luck in the tournament.
Thanks for the momentary lapse in conversation. Ulfie was unquestionably hangry. Now that I am refurbished, I'll allow you to cross. Though a quick-footed peacock already got to that snarling snarlax. Oh, I almost forgot! Goosey, for your act of kindness, Ulfie would like you to have this. Whenever you need me, just give it a blow. Step lively. Ulfie needs to get back to the guild meeting. It's almost croissant time!
Next item up for discussion, should we lift our embargo on the consumption of goats?
Oh, I long for the days of feasting on roasted goat leg with a nice aged raclette.
Pilar! Keep pulling me out of my meeting, and Ulfie hates doing the secret knock!
I'm not sure if he is Royal Guard number one or Royal Guard number two, but I do know he is staring at me, and I don't like it.
Ulfie is here to help.
Hello there. Are you ready to begin?
What exactly are the rules?
The rules are simple, for a change. If you can stay dry, you win.
I'm ready. Let's do this.
All right. Let the duel of strength commence.
I'm glad we can settle this like gentlemen. Want to see if that feather can fly? Alley-oop! One step closer to Squirrel Nation.
I got you, Graham.
I wasn't going to toot that horn anymore until I found the missing piece. Now's probably not the best time for that.
Still one more horn to find.
That didn't...
Tell that smelly guard when you're ready.
You
You should find a way to get all the horns.
Yes.
Bye.
Cheerio.
Sign read, ask us about our free samples.
Oh, custard? Oh, just like my mom used to make.
Oh, I'm saving that pie for a special occasion. Sorry. How can I help?
What happened to your face?
Oh, can you tell? Am I blushing? I'm engaged, Graham. My love, Bramble, said yes.
Oh, that's great. Congratulations. I was actually talking about the welts.
Ah, those are stings from some very angry bees. They tried to ruin our night, but I wouldn't let them. Nothing can come between us and our love.
You keep doing you, Winty. How do I get my free sample?
Well, bring me some bitterroot. It's what I need to finish my walnut strudel. It grows under big, heavy rocks.
Good day.
Have a sweet time.
Hey, Graham. Ready for action?
Bye.
Fortune favors the bold, and Amaya favors the fortune. You can post a work order on anything you want lifted, chopped, or crumbled. Then I'll bring out Mrs. Crumbler to fulfill the order. Hey, Graham. What can I get you?
Bye.
Trust that gut of yours.
That.
Seems like a...
I went through that.
That needs to be used on raisins. Otherwise, you're just wasting it.
That pumpkin was housing too many squirrels for my taste.
Step lively. Alfie needs to get back to the guild meeting. It's almost croissant time.
I'm getting tired of opening that door for him.
If I could find a fast way down there, I would be able to hear the password.
Where do you keep going, Alfie?
Alfie has very important business to attend to. Have the croissants arrived yet?
I already told you. I forgot the croissant, okay? Can we please move on from the croissant?
Guys, I feel like we're talking in circles here.
You'd think with his giant head, there'd be a brain bigger than a macaroon. Alfie, you're so easily tricked into sitting down. You should stand up for our rights. Well, easy.
But Alfie likes sitting down. Pulling me out of my meeting, and Alfie hates doing the secret knock.
Which did you tackle first? Duel of speed or the duel of strength?
Questions?
Bye!
Toodles.
West, Tournament Theater. North, Town Square. South, under development, coming next spring.
Oh, my God.
Seems like a waste of money.
Ew, gross.
Over here. We're waiting. Try to get Pilar's horn. That didn't need to be. Tell that smelly guard when you're ready.
Hello there. Are you ready to try again?
I'm ready. Let's do this.
All right, then. Let the duel of strength commence. Again.
Want to see if that feather can fly? Alley-oop! One step closer to Squirrel Nation.
I got you, Graham.
Almost there. One more horn to find.
The squirrels remember that?
The squirrels will most certainly remember that.
We won't take your money until we've done the job. Bring us something to house that candle, then we'll happily take your money.
Now, give us one shiny gold coin and the beautiful blue flame lantern will be all yours.
Thanks, dearie. And here's your lovely pumpkin lantern with a glowing blue flame candle.
bizarre holes were burrowed into the forest floor.
Hey, how'd my coin get down there? Triumph? How'd you get up there?
Triumph's stomach seemed to have led him into trouble. I'd have to find a way to get him down. That didn't...
You poked?
No poke.
That needs to be used on raisins.
That didn't...
That doesn't... Seems like...
That didn't... fit there.
Stay put, I'll be back with help.
Can we skip through this part? Too much walking, not enough dragons.
Yep.
Make it quick. Alfie needs to head back into his meeting. I was fine viewing that snarly snarlax with the 6 legs, 3 claws, and 1 tooth from this distance. Gross. Down there, I would be able to hear the password.
Alfie, I am going to have to ask you to please remain in the meeting until we are done.
As long as I know the secret password, you still have to let me in.
How How is that the only part of the charter you have memorized?
Next item up for discussion, should we lift our embargo on the consumption of goats?
Oh, I long for the days of feasting on roasted goat leg with a nice aged raclette.
Pilar, everyone knows there are no more goats in Daventry. Only majestic unicorns.
Alfie, there is no such thing.
That's what he had. I've seen him.
Alfie, he pulled a fast one on you. You fathead.
Well, everyone else calls them majestic unicorns.
Alfie, if everyone jumped off a, well, my back, would you?
Who? Is that our croissant delivery?
You'd think with his giant head, there'd be a brain bigger than a macaroon. Alfie, you're so easily tricked into sitting down. You should stand up for our rights. Well, easy.
But Alfie likes sitting down. Helps relieve pressure off my back.
Look, Pilar, I'm on your side, but I need you to work with me.
What's this doing here?
We need to build our bridges and get over this. What's a compromise we can all live with?
Oh, there is no compromise. Those tiny ingrates go around stomping on the shoulders of giants with
shortcut.
No thought as to who
Brilliant.
Is underneath them. They climbed the ladder of success and forgot who got them across their troubled waters. What's in it for us? We will show them all what happens when you cross.
Make it quick. Alfie needs to head back into his meeting.
He is a weak link.
Now, Pilar, I don't know if I'd say it like that.
What is the knock? And a password.
Trust me.
Très bien.
Alfie, I am going to have to ask you to please remain in the meeting until we are done.
As long as I know the secret password, you still have to let me in.
How
is... You must now do the secret knock. You do not belong. Leave.
The next item is a grand council.
You may now perform the secret knock. Très bien. Yes, and... Très bien. Now, speak the secret password.
Trust me?
That is correct. Hold on. Hey, you. You don't look like a troll. You look like a scab. And I love the taste of scabs. Delicious.
He's no scab. He's a goose. And Ulfie's friend. Let him in, Pilar. He might have our snacks.
Any friend of Ulfie's is usually make-believe.
Oh, well, I am actually an imaginary friend.
You are? Then how do we share a pie?
Well, I didn't actually eat any of that pie. So, see? Imaginary.
Ha! Imaginary or not, only trolls are allowed.
Right. Well, in that case, I'm an imaginary troll goose.
You are? Why didn't you just say so?
Well, I know that often bridge trolls from different regions can sometimes be at war, and I'm just here passing through.
Friend or not, you must prove you are indeed a troll. Why don't you join me in the secret dance of the Bridge Troll Guild, and we'll find out.
Yeah. Uh-huh. Can't stop. All right.
Well, there you have it, Pilar. You sure does seem like a troll to me. Mr. Bridge Goose representing Ludor, on behalf of myself, the Grand Counselor of the Daventry Bridge Troll Guild, I would like to welcome you to our chapter meeting. It'll be wonderful to have an outsider's opinion on our strike.
As long as he sides with me, it will be wonderful. Since I am sick of supporting the people of Daventry, I have collected all of the troll horn mouthpieces. They cannot be used anymore.
Golly gosh, Pilar, that seems a bit extreme.
Not extreme enough. We need to destroy these horns once and for all. We need to make a statement. We are not at their beck and call. Daventry has burned their bridges with us, and I will set fire to all these horns.
Where are your horns, Pilar?
Mine are already up on the hill, where I will take all of these. Everyone will be able to see them burn. You, newcomer, throw in whatever is used to summon you. You are a part of this. How cute. A little bridge bell for a little goose.
Okay, well, according to the agenda, the next line item we need to discuss is our negotiation tactics. What is our strategy for getting those guards to stop stomping around on our backs?
Oh, they should cross barefoot without their sharp heels.
I think we should feast on their legs and force them to crawl over our backs.
Okay, now, both interesting perspectives, I hear you, but we gotta find a way for us all to be successful. What do you think, Bridge Goose?
I think I'm with Ulfie on this one.
Thanks. Good thinking, friend.
Point taken. Moving on. Switching topics. Ulfie, it's your turn to bring the snacks next week. Do we want sweet or salty?
Ulfie loves the taste of sweet.
Ulfie, you are an unrefined swine. Savory is the only snack accepted by my palate.
You both bring up good points. But we have to come together on this. What do you think, Bridge Goose?
Oh, there is nothing tastier than a fresh baguette with a few gobs of camembert.
Vive la révolution, Goose.
Okay, continuing forward. We need to decide on our team jackets. The tailor cannot wait any longer for our final decision.
Ulfie is a fan of the majestic unicorn and butterfly logo with the slogan, Building bridges to the future.
No. Our jacket needs to be exciting. We should go with something epic. Something that will burn into their minds. We should go with trolls eating humans. With the slogan, Feed the Trolls.
Okay. Those are both great points. But we really need to find a side to align on and work together. What do you think, Bridge Goose?
I'm gonna go with Ulfie on this. I love butterflies and unicorns.
A bridge to friendship is the best way to solve this.
Next item, negotiation tactics. Getting guards to step softly across our backs.
Make them walk barefoot.
Eat their legs and force them to crawl across.
Guys, I feel like we're talking in circles here.
That's it. Waddles is right. We're repeating ourselves. I'm taking my horn and leaving until you sort this out.
Okay then, this meeting should be adjourned anyway.
I had tricked them. That bell was of little use to me, but Waddle's horn was sure to blow open new paths.
Hey, Waddles!
I like my temper. This fire is not easy to ignite.
That pile was the last horn I needed to complete the set.
Step right up, if you want to get burned. Oh, there must be some more kindling around here. Maybe if I just regain my strength.
She seemed to enjoy snack breaks more than trying to light a fire.
Get away from my raisin croissant. Ils sont à moi. Start, you worthless flame. How to rise. I don't feel so good.
Take a nap.
I need a nap.
This is just a crazy dream. You don't like the taste of lanky teenager.
I now had the complete set.
we used all the rafts. So, figure it out.
Good luck in the duel of strength.
I was just enjoying the most lovely glass of cheese. But no, this is much more important.
Hello there. You're going to try again. You're just going to get thrown off that same side. Ready?
I'm ready. Let's do this.
All right, then. Let the duel of strength commence. Again.
Well, fancy seeing you here again. Wake me when it's over. Alley-oop! One step closer to Squirrel Nation.
Boo! He's cheating with that nasty troll!
Good thinking, Graham!
Look! Look at it, Madeline. Everything the light touches will be yours. The view of victory.
I know it's off-brand, but Acorn can do it!
What's that you say, Princess? He's right behind me.
Oh, don't be nutty.
You know, Madeline, that was rather rude to take his raft all to yourself.
Is there any walnuts true?
Wait! No! Easy! Easy! No one needs to see where this line goes. Careful! Careful! Don't get it tangled! Oh, brother, you shouldn't have done that. Look, I'm no wolf for you to trap. This rope only traps Wetzels, not acorns. We should stop this nonsense and get back to throwing each other into the water. Oh, darn. My trap ropes have gotten all tangled. Good thing I have more colorful rope used only for trapping wolves, only. Let's take a pause from the duel of strength and let's everyone help Acorn gather his deadly rope for killing. Are you pulling my string? As long as we can stay on our feet, he can't get to our little secret. You will never beat me in a tug of war. Boy, you will never trip me up on my own trap. He can't unravel this fast enough if we keep up this pace. Step carefully and focus, Acorn. Gather all the rope. Boy, stop stringing me along. I might have stumbled, but this acorn stays... My trapping ropes. Ugh. Gotcha, skinny pants. Look out below. Ooh, thank God that's over, Madeline. Our secret is safe.
It's not a complete lie. You know, I did trap a Wetzel Wolf in it.
Boo!
Cheetah!
You boiled him again, Graham.
Not again. You really won't like where this rope leads. Careful. Ouch. Ouch. The bull is awakening. Careful, little bean. Some threads aren't meant to be unraveled. You're never gonna get strong if you keep skipping belly day. Ooh, I'm gonna need a warm bath later. Could you give me a neck massage? No? Well, worth a shot.
He's a cheater! But not according to Addendum 4934.
Way to go, Graham!
Hey, there's a reason why I keep my secret roped up. Oh, this is gonna get dark. Okay, fine. My secret will steal your soul. It's Pandora's box. Turn back now. You shouldn't have done that. You almost had me there. Whoa! If you thought keeping a squirrel friend in my belly was weird, you won't be able to handle what's at the end of this line. Are you pulling my string? Unraveling this string will unleash a demon on Daventry. Seriously, a Drosdek demon. You know, the kind that will rain fire and brimstone for years on end. You'll doom us all. You will never beat me in a tug of war. Ugh, so many knots. That's why my belly's so big. It's full of secrets. I might have stumbled, but this acorn stays planted. I warned you. You shouldn't have done that. Hey, there's a reason why I keep my secret roped up. Oh, this is gonna get dark. Okay, fine. My secret will steal your soul. It's Pandora's box. Turn back now. No! The Drosdek demon!
Now is the time for the laughing and the ridicule.
Oh, brother. No, stop. You're making it worse. Eek!
It's still funny!
Give me
here,
back
take
my...
it back!
Worth it!
Got stuck to my hand! I don't want this!
Hold still!
Sorry, I'm not sorry!
Madeline, chew this off me! As much fun as this is...
It's crumbling time!
Wow!
It's magnificent!
It's extraordinary!
I knew you had it in you.
With the help of some trolls and Manny, I had bested that giant and revealed his weakness. I was one step closer to the knighthood, but I didn't feel that great about it.
Hello! Down here! We could all use a lift, you know! Yes! Yes! Right this way!
No, Alfie! Stop! Oh, I've had it with their orders. The time is now! Let's show these ingrate what happens when you cross the wrong bridge! How does it feel to be stepped on?
Run!
Run! Come back here, you pointy boots!
No! Oh, Pilar, stop! This is going to cause a boatload of unnecessary paperwork!
Wait for Alfie, guys!
So, I have to ask...
You have the gall to be asking me for anything? You're gonna be asking for your life soon.
You know, Acorn, I could use your strength on that boulder over there.
We are not friends. Enjoy your hand-knitted sock. Go away!
See you around.
Is that a fat joke? You disgust me!
Oh, my sock. I thought it was ruined.
Look, I wanted to sincerely apologize for what happened back there. Things got a little out of hand and weird.
I shouldn't have exploded. People always see me as the big guy. But my dream is to open a craft store. I'm just here to please my parents.
Well, your crafts are lovely. Really stunning, actually.
No one's ever complimented me on my work before. Well, except the squirrels. Thanks, Graham. That means a lot.
Oh, my pleasure. Let me know if you ever want to sell them. I might be able to rustle up one shiny gold coin.
Well, this is silly. They're just socks. Here, take them. They might run a little big on you, but you could always wear them over your shoes. Like slippers.
Wow, thanks.
My pleasure. Hey, Graham.
You know, Acorn, I could use your strength on that boulder over there.
Yeah, no problem, little buddy. There might be a surprise for you under there.
Why did you want to work for the Kingdom of Daventry anyway?
I guess I saw potential in it. It certainly wasn't the kingdom you know today, but I've never shied away from a creative project.
Yes?
Bye.
Toodaloo.
I really... Ah! Just what I needed to finish my walnut strudel! Here is your free sample.
Are you trying to grease my palm? Well, good luck. My hands are very sticky, especially in this heat. Ooh, quite fashionable.
Ah, what a most love.
Hey, Graham. What can I get you?
Bye.
Forget what those other guys say. A sword is mightier than a pen. Don't know how you got the coin to get one of these. You can't even afford proper armor for yourself. Nevertheless, stick that on anything you want chopped, lifted, or crumbled. And the Crumbler and I will get to work. Back away from the Crumbler. Unless you have 50 gold coins for a work order. Don't know how you got the coin to get one of these. You can't even afford proper armor for yourself. Nevertheless, stick that on anything you want chopped, lifted, or crumbled. And the Crumbler and I will get to work. You can post a work order on anything you want lifted, chopped, or crumbled. Then I'll bring out Mrs. Crumbler to fulfill the order.
Yeast. Ugh.
I was fine viewing that snarly snarlax with the 6 legs, 3 claws, and 1 tooth from this distance. Gross.
Hey, Pilar. You seem refreshed.
I was just enjoying the most lovely glass of cheese. But no, this is much more important.
Zounds! The castle had a moat monster? Did you train him? Did he do tricks? What was his favorite treat? Was he a fresh or seawater monster?
No, Gwendolyn. This part of the story is merely foreshadowing.
That means I have to wait, doesn't it?
I'm afraid so.
I hope you clean your shoes. I'm sure you're tracking Wetzel droppings all across my back.
I would need a lot more for a bribe.
Ooh, quite fashionable.
That crumbler is so expensive. Bring your trusted steed to the tournament theatre when you're ready for the duel of speed. You do have a trusted steed, don't you? Please remove that from these premises.
Seeing that you're so willing to throw away art, it seems like the mystery of my disappearance.
That job was no match for the Crumbler. Easy money.
Triumph! Hey, buddy! Was the steak good at least? So, I know you just fell out of a tree and all, but there's this duel of speed and I kinda sorta... Couldn't have said it better myself. We're off! I can't say this is the most peculiar thing I've seen today.
Don't mind us.
Just getting a bit of exercise, really.
It's leg day.
My name is Larry. This is Kyle.
Graham. We know. We've been watching you.
We think you show potential.
You got our support.
Well, thanks.
You're welcome. We've got your back.
If you ever need us, just holler. Like this. Hey!
Good luck in the duels.
The duel of speed. The only thing racing was my mind. How was I going to get out of this one?
Eat my cape!
Graham!
Victory is mine! Take that, Gideon! Whisper runs from danger! My armor is too beautiful for smudges!
Branches!
Watch your head, Jermaine! Jerry, I can't see! Watch the main!
Go left!
Left!
Move right!
Got it!
Go right!
Gotcha!
Left!
Gotcha!
Go left!
Got it!
Stress!
Got you covered, Graham!
What type of stunt are you trying to pull?
I bet you couldn't win this race. Backwards.
What? Hey, Whisper can do it.
Whisper! Bet you can't win this race. Standing on your hands.
Whisper can do it.
Addendum 2, Section 5 states another lap.
Hop, 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 hop.
You can't win this race. Standing on your hands.
Whisper can do it.
Ah!
Whisper regrets his past decision.
Nice one, Graham!
Told you not to skip leg day.
Whisper! Bet you can't win this race... backwards.
Whisper can do it!
We can so do this, Graham!
Look back at your own reflection.
Whisper! Bet you can't win this race... and share your legends with those guards.
Whisper can do it! At last, the ivory monster unveiled itself. What? Hey, Whisper can do it!
Come back, Whisper! I was so interested in your story! Way to go, Graham!
Oh. Nice one,
are you talking
Graham?
To Graham?
We knew you could do it!
Graham!
It seemed my alliance with Manny worked. He easily bested Acorn in the duel of speed and defeated Whisper in the duel of strength. I headed to the theater to square off against my friend in the championship duel of wits.
an autograph, you say? You're still Whisper's fan? You want to immortalize me on your nightstand? Well, I'm not one to disappoint the fans. Here you are. To my fan. Graham. Right? Always seek adventure. Signed, Whisper. Thanks, friend. I needed that. Hello.
Hey, Whisper. Do you think you could help me catch a frog?
Whisper can do it. These evil dragon hoppers are no match for Whisper. Anything for a fair end.
I need a bigger pan, please.
Yes. Give it here, boy.
Oh, that did the trick. Splendid. Our teeth whitening potion is complete, thanks to you.
Yep. And a promise is a promise. Here is your sample, boy. Got anything that needs a color changing, you know, something that needs to stand out from the rest?
Use it wisely, dear. There's only one dose in there.
Wish that teeth whitening potion would have worked. I'd never brush my teeth again.
I'm not sure that's how it works, sweetheart.
questions?
Where is the championship duel?
The championship duel of wits will be held at the theater. I believe Manny is waiting for you there.
Bye.
Toodles.
All right, I'll try something else. I hope you find this to your liking, Princess Madeline of Avalon.
The tension between the Bridge Troll Guild and the Royal Guards is at an all-time high. And we need to come to an agreement soon.
You bridges need to stop stonewalling us and give us your demands.
We need you to watch your step when crossing our backs. Give more respect to the giant whose shoulders you're stomping on.
Well, we need you to stop complaining and get back to work.
We are sick of getting walked all over. You're just looking at the problem from your perspective. We all have to work together.
The problem is there are no bridges. You're a bridge, and you're not doing your job.
Oh, jeez. We've been doing our job for generations. You've worn us down, and we need you to think about a softer touch.
Your agreement with Daventry clearly states you are to provide bridge services at the designated locations.
And it states that you are to be kind to the bridges. While we're hardy structures, we also feel each and every step you take.
I'm sorry. The issue remains. We need you to return to work.
And we need you to stop sharpening your boots every night.
That's impossible. We're required by the guard mandate to maximize boot sharpness every evening.
Oh, come on, work with me here. All we're asking is for you guys to take lighter steps.
And not conduct the official march? Never. Tradition dictates the harshness of our steps.
Then perhaps you need to change your official march from flamboyant huffing a boot to graceful gliding in soft shoes.
No can do. It took us months to memorize our current march.
Oh, you're always crossing us, and this time we are holding strong for a compromise.
If you continue to suspend your services, King Edward will banish you to the pit of never-ending itches.
Gersh, I just need you to find a way to work with me here.
Back to work!
Softer steps!
Stop eating guards!
Better maintenance!
Longer hours!
Weekends off!
Stop eating snoots! I have no time to listen to additional opinions. We need these bridges to get back to work.
Stop the stomping!
Stop the stomp!
Sorry, Graham, but we don't need any more opinions. We need solutions. We need you to watch your step when crossing our...
Ooh, for me? Oh, they feel as though I am walking on clouds. And the craftsmanship, stunning. Can you order one pair for each of the Royal Guards?
Well, it does look soft and cuddly, but that's not accounted for in your mandate.
I could create an addendum for that. We could still sharpen our boots and march as we wish, but these socks would protect you.
Oh, jeez, that would just be the best. A real compromise that we could all live with.
I think that's exactly what you should do.
Thanks, Graham. The Guild will never forget this. See you at the next meeting.
The new socks offer the guards souls. It was definitely a step in the right direction.
I'm warming up to these.
I'm just glad the trolls never had to suffer the agony of defeat.
Graham, glad you made it. Take a seat. Welcome, friend, to the championship duel of wits. Well, the take-home version. Budget cuts or something. But, look around, take it all in, and know, we've already won. Our allegiance guarantees us both a spot on King Edward's court.
How exactly is this going to work?
Before we get to the rules, I offer a toast and an opportunity. You see, while this game might stretch the imagination, for some I find it rather simple and in need of an additional mental challenge. Guards, the raisin juice, please. This is my favorite game, though it's been a long time since I last played it. Are you familiar with hypnotic powder? One sip of this, and you'll have to do everything I say. And, of course, vice versa. In goes the powder. Guard number two, if you would. I'll take this one. Whoa! Looks like you got the winner. And now, we play. This is getting absurd. How many times do I have to beat you? I wish I had other powders to make this game more interesting.
I've seen enough magic powders for one day.
Can you believe what that brute was hiding in his belly? What a disappointment.
I actually liked his art. I'm not proud of embarrassing him.
Graham, that dope will never accept us. He should keep to the knitting. Whisper, though, eh? Finally got a taste of his own medicine.
He's not that bad once you get to know him.
Are you getting soft on me, Graham? Do you have any other secret alliances I should know about? You had a run-in with some goblins.
I did.
Nasty creatures, really. Ugh. But be careful around them. They're smarter than they look. I wouldn't notice that. Shame about Achaka, though.
I can't focus on this game. I keep thinking about him.
Well, once we're in the castle, we can make sure his people, the Pitchthrians, get the surplus they need. It's the least we can do. Did you visit that magic shop in town?
I did. The Hobblepots have minds of their own.
Yes, well, I just wish they'd get serious about the potential of their wares. What do you think about this? You go there. Interesting move. What? How did I not notice that? Don't screw this up for me, Graham. Oh, Graham, you were so close, so close! Oh, Graham, you were so close, so close! Oh, Graham, you were so close, so close! Eesh, I thought you had me. I'm all for thinking it through, but a little deftness in decision-making never hurt a soul. Oh, Graham, you were so close, so close! Don't worry, Graham. You'll always be my number two. Carefully about your next move.
I am ready for decree 3, 2, 1, 4.6 and a half.
Actually, I think it was decree 1.21.
Aha! We knew you could do it.
You're out of the alliance. I can't lose to you. How about another challenge? We only got to square off in a duel of wits. A well-rounded gentleman would win in a duel of strength as well.
Graham, take this.
Challenge. How would you fare in a duel of speed?
No, Manny. It's over. Just as the battle isn't always claimed by the strong, and the race isn't always won by the swift, sometimes the intelligent falter. And I think now is my chance. And now is my time.
Come on, Graham. One more duel for Achaka. Do it for the village of starving Pitch-3ans.
Oh, you said his village was home to the Itch-2ins. What exactly is your plan here? Cause I'm starting
to... Duel of speed!
No, Graham, he's not worth it.